Hi students, today in this video we go for the new chapter, chapter number 8. The name of the chapter is A Short Monsoon Diary. Here is one diary, here one diary is given, and the writer of this diary is Ruskin Bond. So let's start. And here is chapter A Short Monsoon Diary. Here one introduction paragraph is given that before you read the chapter, you have to know this. Do you know that what a diary is? Here the definition of diary is given that. Do you know that what's a diary? Diary called, it is a record of personal experience written day after day over a long period of time. It is a record of personal experience that written day after day over a long period. You can also use a diary to note down things you plan to do immediately or in future. We can use a diary to note down the things that we want to do and in the future, or we want to do immediately, means we in emergency we want to do. So it is a planning. One of the most famous diaries published as a book is the Diary of Anne Frank. One of the most the famous diary, the Diary of Anne Frank. I hope you be familiar with this, that Diary of Anne Frank. I hope that you read this book, the Diary of Anne Frank. It is a great book. Here are a few extracts from Ruskin Bond's diary, in which he portrays the silent miracles of nature and in life's little joys and regrets. Read on. Here Ruskin Bond, the writer's diary is given, and in this diary he describes the silent miracles of nature, and life's little joys and regrets, little joys and sorrows. So read on this chapter. So let's start the chapter. And here is the first part of the chapter. It is the date June 24, the description of this day. The first day of monsoon mist. And it's strange how all the birds fall silent as the mist comes climbing up the hill. The writer says that the first day of monsoon mist means fog. And it is very strange that the mist covers whole hill. Perhaps that's what makes the mist so melancholy. Not only does it conceal the hills, it blankets them in silence too. The writer says that perhaps what makes the mist so melancholy. Melancholy means very sad, because it not conceal means cover. It not cover only the hills, but it covers, blankets means covers. It covers the whole hill in silence too. Only an hour ago, the trees were ringing with bird song. Before some time, the trees were ringing means the birds were singing in the trees, and now the forest is deathly still, as though it were midnight. And now the forest is deathly means very silent because of mist, and though it were midnight. So now the forest became silent of the mist, silent because of the mist. Through the mist, Bizu is calling to his sister. Now Bizu is one boy that lives on that hill. So he is calling his sister. I can hear him running about on the hillside, but I cannot see him because of mist. The writer says that I can hear the voice of Bizu, but I cannot see him because there was so much mist on the hillside, and so I can only hear the voice of Bizu. So this is the first paragraph, and now we go for the next. And here is the second page, and the date is June 25. The description of that date: some genuine early monsoon rain, warm and humid. Now writer says that the monsoon rain was warm and humid. Warm means hot, and humid means very with mist, and not that cold high altitude stuff we have been having all year. Altitude means high, height above, stuff we have been having all year. The plants seem to know it too. and the first cobra really rears its head from the ferns as I walk up to the bank and post office. The writer says that when I walk up to the bank and post office, the first cobra really, it is a type of a plant that rears, means raises its head from the ferns. From the ferns, ferns means flowerless plant. When poet walk up at the bank or the post office, he saw that cobra really raise up its head from the ferns. The mist affords a certain privacy. Affords means gives. The mist gives certain privacy because no one can see one another in the mist. A schoolboy asked me to describe the hill station and valley in one sentence. Now the writer says that one schoolboy came to me and said that describe this atmosphere in one sentence, and all I could say was a paradise that might have been. Now the poet, the writer described this atmosphere in only one sentence, and this sentence is a paradise that might have been, means a paradise means heaven. It is a heaven that we never seen. So this is the description of June 25, and now we go for the next one. And here is the description of June 27, that the rains have heralded the arrival of some seasonal visitors, a leopard and several thousand leeches. Here the leopard and leeches are the name of an animals, name of the animals, and the rain, the monsoon, heralded means announced to arrival. Arrival means some seasonal visitors came, like animals like leopard and thousand of leeches came to that hill. Yesterday afternoon, the leopard lifted a dog from near the servants' quarter below the school. Now the writer noticed that yesterday one event happened, that one leopard lifted a dog from the servants' quarter. In the evening, it attacked on the Biju's cows, but fled at the approach of Biju's mother. At evening, leopard tried to attack on the Biju's cows, but it fled away because of approach of Biju's mother, who came screaming imprecations. She shouted more, and that's why the leopard ran away. As for the leeches, I shall soon get used to a little bloodletting every day. And there are many more leeches came, so I shall soon get used. The leeches is an animal that used for blood letting from the body, that the writer says I can use these leeches every day, because great amount of leeches were there. Other new arrivals are the scarlet minivets flitting silently among the leaves. Now some birds came on that hill, and one of them is scarlet minivet, means the females are yellow. It is a red colored bird like a cuckoo. And flitting means walking. It walking silently among the leaves like brilliant jewels. It walking very silently, and no matter how leafy the trees, these brightly colored birds cannot conceal themselves, although by remaining absolutely silent. This bird is remain absolutely silent, but here it cannot conceal, means cover themselves. These birds cannot cover themselves because they sometimes contrive to go unnoticed. Sometimes these birds discover, means we can't discover these birds, and they are very silent. Along come a pair of drongos, unnecessarily aggressive, chasing the minivets away. Now the drongos is a songbird with a stout bill. It is also a bird, and they chasing the minivets, and they ran away. They fled away the minivets. So these are the birds that came in monsoon on the hill. And now we go for the next page, and here is the last paragraph of this part one. A tree creeper moves rapidly up the trunk of the oak tree. Now the writer describes the oak tree, that the creeper moves rapidly the trunk of the oak tree. Oak tree is a type of a tree snapping up insects all the way. Now there are many insects on the tree. Because of rain, they came out from their holes. Now the rains are there. There is no dearth of food for the insectivorous birds. Insectivorous birds means birds who eat only insects, and they have no dearth means shortage of food because of insects. There are many insects on the tree, and they have many more. They have much food to eat. So this is the last paragraph of part one, and here in this first part, the 3 days description is given, that June 24, June 25 and June 27. And you can read this part 1 from the page number 109, 110 and 111 of your Honeydew textbook. I hope you understood. In the next video, we will see the second part of this chapter. Thank you.